Welcome to Punarvasi Technologies. www.punarvasi.com is my website. I wrote many articles in this website. Many people got benefited from my articles. My name is Mr. Raz. I am SAP Basis Retriever International Trainer. I have trained students in more than 50 countries. In this video, I will demonstrate how to navigate within SAP Service Marketplace. To log on to the SAP Service Marketplace, you need to have S user ID and password. Only the people who works in SAP companies like SAP customer companies or SAP partners will have this particular S user ID and password. And SAP certified professionals also will have S user ID. But limited authorizations. If you want to have full authorization, you have to contact the super administrator. You have to contact super administrator of your company. Open any of the browser. Type service. .sap.com, hit enter. So here SAP support portal, this is a new link and this is the old link, that is SAP support portal link. As soon as you click on here, it will ask you to enter the S user ID and password. Just I am clicking on it, and click login. Again, it will ask you to enter the S user ID and password. Just click on the login button. So this is the inside of SAP Service Marketplace. From here you can look at different quick links available for your SAP administration. So these are all the quick links available from A to Z. Example, for suppose if you want to download the software, SWDC is the link, SWDC, SAP Software Distribution Center download. If you click on here, it will go to software downloads. And if you want to look at patches, you have to click on /patches. Okay. And this is about quick links link, and also you have different tabs here like help and support, software downloads, keys and requests, data administration, maintenance and services, SAP solution manager, release and upgrade information, knowledge exchange. Most of the time you will use help and support and software downloads. And if you want to request keys, you have to use this particular tab. I'll show you this particular tab, that is software downloads. Click on the software downloads. The SWDC quick link which I have shown, same screen will be displayed. Okay, from here, click on the installations and upgrades. And go to A2Z index or browse our download catalog. And from here we'll have different classification of different softwares. Out of these softwares, SAP application components are the main softwares. Click on the SAP application components so that it will display all the application components of SAP software. For suppose if you want to look at SAP ERP system, you need to click on SAP ERP. Click on SAP ERP, and Here, SAP ERP 6.0 is the base software. SAP ERP enhancement package is the latest software. Click on the SAP enhancement package to look at different versions available. Out of these versions, EHP 7 for SAP ERP 6.0 is the latest one. Click on it. If you want to download or install IDS version, means sample company data, if you want to have within the SAP ECC system, you have to click on IDS version. If you don't want to have the sample company information, just you click on installation and upgrade link from here. Okay, and if you look at the information, if you click on that link, it will display different types of databases on which you can install this particular SAP ECC software. Out of these databases, you can choose Oracle or ASE, that is Sybase software, or HANA, MaxDB, IBM DB2 and DB2 UDB. If you want to install SAP software on Oracle database, click on the Oracle database. I have recorded all the videos using Oracle database, that's why I mostly use the Oracle database. You can use different database software also if you want. And once you learn on one database, the same topics will be there on the other databases also. Okay, from here you can look at the information about the different files available. These are all the files available, and this is SAP ERP 6.0 EHP 7 SR1 installation export 1/2 and 2/2. These two files are export files. These two file size is more, that is 3 GB, and this is 1.6 GB, and these two are required, and this one also installation export 2 also required. And the languages, if you need languages, you have to download these files, otherwise you can leave it. And the Java components, that is AS Java, if you want to install, you need to download this software. And that's all. And the next thing is that you need to have the installation master, that is SWPM, that is software provisioning manager. To start the installation of SAP system, you need to have the installation master. Maybe you have seen my videos how to install SAP Netweaver software using installation master. It will have the kernel files also. Once you have all the files with you, you can install the software. That is quickly a brief introduction about how to download the software. Once you have these files, what you have to do is you have to select the file. Like for suppose if you want to download this particular file, select the file and click on the add to download basket, so that it will be added to the download basket like this. So this is the download basket. Click on the download basket here to look at the information, and this is the information. This is the file which I have chosen just now. And to download this particular file, you need to install SAP download manager, which can be downloaded from the get the SAP download manager from here. So once you download this get SAP download manager, you can install in your laptop just like other Windows programs. This icon will be displayed once the SAP download manager is installed. Just you have to click on this particular SAP download manager shortcut, that is program icon, to open the SAP download manager. So you need to wait for some time to get that particular software up. So once it appears, it should display that particular file which we have selected, we have added to the download basket. So where is the download basket? Where it is? This one. This is the file. Okay, so you have to choose the file and click on this particular button to start the download. So before starting it, what you have to do is go to view and click on the download manager configuration, so that you can set the path where it should store, download store. So from here you can create a separate folder anywhere in your computer to store that particular file. Once that download store is configured, just select the file and click on this particular button to start the download. Okay, so that's all about this downloading software. I hope you got an idea. So next thing is that let me delete that particular file from the download basket. So select it and click on the delete button. So once click on OK, that will be disappeared from here. And once you finish the download, that particular file will jump into the download history and it will be displayed here. From here also you can delete that particular file. So right now I have not downloaded, that's why I'm selecting from here and click on the delete button, click on OK. So in this way you have to use the download manager to download the software from the SAP Service Marketplace. And next thing is that there is a help and support tab. From here you can search for the notes. For suppose if you have the note number, you have to type the note number here to get the information about that particular note. Like for suppose if you want to search for something like NetWeaver, so it will display all the notes related to the NetWeaver. Okay, click on the go button. It will display all the notes available. Notes means it will give you the correction information like problem and solution. Whenever you have some problem related to that problem, there will be a notes available. You can use the notes to get the solution for your problem, like SAP notes, wrong input data. Just note number, I wanted to find out the note number. Where is the note number? So this is actually the notes number. For suppose if you know the notes number, copy from here, you can put the note number here and click on the go button so that directly that particular note will be opened. So once it is opened, you can click on the PDF version to store that particular notes as PDF version, or directly you can read the information from these notes. And other related notes also available here. You see, this is also one more note number. So like this, you can use that SAP help and support for getting the information about different notes. And there is another tab called keys and requests. From here you can request the keys, license keys. Okay, there is a select it from a list. So these are all the different systems available in this organization. And once you get into the SAP Service Marketplace, you can play with it. So just this is an introduction about SAP Service Marketplace. I hope you got some idea about SAP Service Marketplace. And if you want to download some patches, like software downloads, and go to support packages and patches, go to A to Z. And in the same way how you have used the A to Z link in installation and upgrades, in the same way you can search for the patches also, like for suppose ERP patches you can get from here. SAP ERP, like this. Okay, so that's all. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or doubts, you can leave your comments under this video. Thanks for watching.